Hello students of 7th class, this is Riya Gupta and we will study science, and in science we will study the chapter Nutrition in Plants. I hope you all are ready. So let's start with the chapter. So what is nutrition? Okay, so we have to start firstly by the meaning of nutrition in nutrition. Then only we will understand that what is a nutrition in plants. So see everyone, nutrition is a mode of taking the food by an organism and its utilization by the body. What is the meaning of this line? It is that process by which any organism is taking the food and using that food for its activities which are going on in their body. Okay, means the process by which the organisms are taking the food and then utilizing that food for the activities which are going on in our body, that process is known as nutrition. What is present in the food? Actually, there are some components of the food like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals. These all are collectively known as nutrients. So, you know, nutrients are required for our body for their growth, for repair and for providing energy. So, these all are being provided to the organism. These all are taken by the organism so that they can grow. Okay, so that process by which they are taking these components of the food and utilizing this component of the food is known as nutrition. Okay, now in this chapter we will study about the plants. So plants are getting the nutrition in the different ways. There are two ways plants are broadly classified into two, that is autotrophs and heterotrophs. So those plants who are autotrophs, their mode of nutrition is autotrophic mode of nutrition, and those plants which are heterotrophs, their mode of nutrition is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so now see, what is autotrophic mode of nutrition? Otherwise, what is autotroph? If I say what is autotrophic mode of nutrition, the mode of nutrition in which plants can prepare their own food. Okay, and those plants who can prepare their own food, they are known as autotrophs, and the mode of nutrition is known as autotrophic. You know, these autotrophs are of two types. First is photoautotrophs and second is chemoautotrophs. What are photoautotrophs? Those are getting their energy for making food from the sunlight. They are known as photoautotrophs. Okay, and those are getting the chemical energy, those who are using the chemical energy to make their food, they are known as the chemoautotrophs. Okay, next type of nutrition is there, that is heterotrophic mode of nutrition. And in those, the plants and animals who are dependent on autotrophs for the nourishment. Plants and animals which are dependent upon autotrophs for the nourishment, they are known as the heterotrophs, and the mode of nutrition is known as heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so these were the classification of the nutrition. Again, I'm revising. See, nutrition are of two types. There are two modes of nutrition, autotrophic mode of nutrition and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Those plants who can prepare their own food, they are known as autotrophic mode of nutrition. Those plants and animals who are dependent on others, on the autotrophs for their nourishment, they are known as heterotrophs. Okay. Now, these autotrophs are also divided in two parts, that is photoautotrophic and chemoautotrophics. Photoautotrophs are those who are preparing their food in the presence of sunlight, and chemoautotrophs are those who are using chemical energy to make their food. Okay, now see, those autotrophs are there who can make their own food. They are generally using this process, that is photosynthesis, for the preparation of food. Okay, so what is photosynthesis? The process by which plants can prepare their food, that process is known as photosynthesis. But what happens in the photosynthesis, that we will see with the help of a diagram. But before that, I want to show you one thing. See, this is a structure of leaf, and you know, at the lower surface of the leaf, mostly the numbers of stomata are present. What are stomata? Stomata are the tiny pores which are present on the lower surface of the leaf. It is also present on the upper surface, but in less amount. Mostly they are present on the lower surface of the leaf. Okay, So these are known as stomata. This which structure you are seeing, this one structure, this is the magnified structure of stomata. When you will see the leaf under the microscope, then you can see the stomata structure is this shape. Okay, in this pore is there, some space is there, hole is there, this, okay, and this is a guard cell which is protecting it. Now come to the process, what is photosynthesis? So see, suppose this is a green plant. Okay, why it is green? Because it is having chlorophyll in it, the green color pigment which is present in plants, which make the plants leaves green. Okay, that green color pigment is known as chlorophyll. So what this plant used to do, it used to take water from the roots, carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, sunlight from the sun, and chlorophyll is already present in this. So in by using these all, they are producing the food, they are manufacturing the food. That food which is formed after using all this is known as glucose. Okay, and with this oxygen is also released. You can see the equation of photosynthesis. This equation tells us the summary of photosynthesis, like 6CO2 plus 6H2O in the presence of sunlight, this is UV sunlight, and chlorophyll, C6H12O6 sugar plus 6O2 is formed. This is carbon dioxide, this is water, this is glucose, and this is oxygen. Okay, and with this some amount of water, moisture is also released from the stomata. Okay, so this equation used to tell about the photosynthesis, that in the presence of carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, and chlorophyll, this is a food, plant is preparing their food. Okay, and what food they are preparing? They are preparing glucose. The name is given is as C6H12O6. Its formula is C6H12O6, and with this some amount of oxygen is released. Okay, you can say this oxygen is a byproduct of the photosynthesis. Okay, which is released during the stomata during daytime. At night photosynthesis cannot take place, because at night sunlight is not there. Okay, and for this photosynthesis they require sunlight. Okay, so without photosynthesis, you know, life would not be possible, because we not each and every living organism is ultimately dependent on the plants for their food. Okay, so photosynthesis is a very important process. You know, plants are the producers, means they are making their own food with the help of photosynthesis. Okay, so the presence of plant is must for us. Absence of plant, people cannot imagine the survival of any living organism in the absence of plant, because they not only provide food, these plants are not only providing us food, they are providing oxygen to us. And you know, oxygen is very important for the respiration. Okay, for us oxygen is very important because we are breathing all the time. So plants are very important. See, synthesis of plant food other than carbohydrates like C6H12O6, which glucose was formed, that is a carbohydrate. Other than this, what plants are preparing, what food these plants are taking? Okay, so you see, plants also prepare protein with the help of nitrogen, which is obtained from the soil. Plants are also preparing the protein with the help of nitrogen. So if somebody asks what is the food other than carbohydrates, so that food which is produced by the plants other than carbohydrates is the protein. How they are converting, how they are making it? These microorganisms are there, like a small organism. They are converting the atmospheric nitrogen, which nitrogen is present in the atmosphere, they're converting into the water soluble compounds, and these are absorbed by the roots of the plant. Okay, so which minerals dissolve in water are used to convert the sugar into the carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. So which means in the water, which minerals are present, they used to convert the sugar into carbohydrates, proteins and fats. These food components form the source of nutrients for other heterotrophic plants and animals. So same we will study other mode of nutrition in plant. So I told you second mode of nutrition in plants was there, that is heterotrophic. You know this thing very well, that all the plants are not green in color. It means all the plants don't have chlorophyll. Those plants who are having chlorophyll, they can prepare their own food, okay, in the presence of chlorophyll with the help of photosynthesis. But those who don't have chlorophyll, how will they prepare the food? So for them other modes of nutrition is there. What is other modes of nutrition? See, firstly understand the meaning of this, that those who are unable to produce the food with the help of photosynthesis, these are heterotrophs. They are dependent on the autotrophs for the food. Same we will see how they are dependent. First we have, that is parasite. What we have? Parasites. You know, one plant is there, that is cuscuta. Which one? Cuscuta. This cuscuta used to grow on the other plant. What? This cuscuta used to grow on the other plant. Okay? And what is used to do? It used to suck the food from other plants by using the root-like structures. Okay? And the plants from which they get food, they are called host. And since they deprive the host plant of the valuable nutrients, they are called parasites. Firstly, what is the meaning of host and parasite that you see? Suppose you have seen a monkey, you know, on monkey lice is living. Lice, okay, so this lice is living on the body of monkey. So what this lice is doing, this lice is taking the nutrition from the monkey's body and then using it as their food. So what is lice? Lice is a parasite, that organism which is living on the other organism for food. That organism which is living on the other organism for food, that is known as the parasite. Okay, and though that one organism, like monkey, which is providing the food, okay, that is known as host. So same is there, like one plant is there, cuscuta. This cuscuta used to grow on the other plant. Okay, and what they used to do? They used to suck the food from other plants by using root-like structure. This cuscuta is having some root-like structure. By that, they used to suck the food from the other plant. So, what is this cuscuta? This cuscuta is a parasite because it is living on the other plant, and this other plant is acting as a host. Okay, next mode of nutrition is there, that is insectivores. What is insectivores? Insectivorous mode of nutrition is seen in plants such as a pitcher plant and Venus flytrap. Okay, what are these? You can simply say these insect-eating plants are known as insectivorous plant. What are insectivorous plants? Insect-eating plants are known as insectivorous plants. Okay, so see, this is an example of Venus flytrap. And this is example of pitcher plant. This is a picture of pitcher plant and this is Venus flytrap. You can see, I am taking the example of Venus flytrap. See, how they are making their food. See, these can make their food by the help of photosynthesis. But there is some lack of nutrients. What is the lack of nutrients in this? That is, nitrogen is not there in these kind of the plant. Okay, and some other minerals are also not there. So what happened? Because of that, the leaves of these plants are modified into a trap. This you are seeing the trap. This is a trap. So they are modified into a trap with a hairy wall which is coming out. This is small hair like structure. These are the hairy wall. Actually what happened, when any insect enters in this trap, so this lid is there. This lid used to get close. Okay, and the prey, like that insect, get entangled in the hair. Obviously that insect will try to come out, so it cannot come out, it will entangle in this hair. Okay, so what happened? This plant, as the insect goes into the body of this plant then digests its prey to obtain the required nutrients which were lacking. So these insect eating plants are known as the insectivorous plants. Okay, next mode of nutrition is there, that is saprotrophs. What is saprotrophs? Some plants are obtaining their nutrition from the dead and decaying matter. From where? Some plants are obtaining their nutrition from the dead and decaying matter. Okay, so that mode of nutrition is known as the saprophytic mode of nutrition. Okay, saprotrophs are generally the decomposers and they are obtaining the energy from their own use by breaking down complex organic matter from the dead organism of other organism. Dead bodies of other organism. What is the meaning of this? Actually, those organism, those plants, these are feeding on other dead organism, and after feeding on them, they are using that food, that organism, and breaking it into the nutrients. Like, you know, the example of fungi. Suppose any bread is there. Okay, if you keep bread in open, so what will happen? This bread, after 1-2 days, it will start to get, obviously, after 1-2 days, what? It will get spoiled within a day if it is kept in open. So what happened? Fungi will come and will sit on this and will take the nutrition from this. Okay, so this process is known, this fungi is a saprotrophs, and this method, this mode of nutrition is known as saprotrophic mode of nutrition. Next and last mode of nutrition is there, that is symbiosis. What is symbiosis? There are some organisms which live together and they share their shelter and nutrients. Okay, I am telling you this with the help of example. See, this is a plant. Actually, this plant is leguminous plant. Which one? Leguminous plant. Which kind of plant is this? This is a leguminous plant. This, what is the quality of this leguminous plant? That these used to have root nodules in their roots. What? These circle-like structure you are seeing? These are the root nodules which are present in the roots of the plant. Now what happened? In this root nodules, rhizobium bacteria is living. This rhizobium bacteria is taking the atmospheric nitrogen, and then converting this atmospheric nitrogen into the nitrates. What it is doing? It is taking the atmospheric nitrogen and converting this into the nitrates and then allowing it to replenish in the soil. Okay, so by these nitrates are providing the nutrients to the soil. After that, what happened? When these plants die, then it come in the ground again. So by that dead plant also we are getting some nitrogen, and by that nitrogen new plants are being grown. So firstly, this is a kind of nitrogen cycle also, we can say. Okay, we can say that this is a nitrogen fixing, where we are fixing, like we are changing one form of a nitrogen into the other form. Okay, but how does it tell about the symbiosis? Like, you see, these plants are providing the space, shelter to the rhizobium to live. Okay, and what is rhizobium doing in turn of this? Rhizobium is converting the atmospheric nitrogen into the nitrates. So what they are doing? They are, these rhizobium and plant, they both are living together. Okay, and they are helping and sharing their shelter and helping for nutrients also. Like, they used to provide them shelter, plants used to provide shelter to the rhizobium, and rhizobium in turn return nutrients to this plant so that more plants can be grow. Okay, so this process is known as symbiosis. I hope you understood this chapter. Okay, this chapter was very important. Now this chapter is finished. So we will meet in next video. Bye everyone.